In some ways, the modern world is a world created by commerce. For humanity, the transfer of goods and services is a special hobby. From this exchange, the flow of people and the intermixing of cultures has been unceasing. Like this, commerce has shortened the distance between China and the rest of the world. Not only do footsteps define oneself, they can also measure distance and open a path to the future. These 90 youths from Ethiopia are currently undergoing training in a Chinese factory. Over a period of 380 days, they will receive instruction on professional technique and cultural management.
It's hard to work together, isn't it? With team exercises, we teach them not like that or that, like this. We treat this like boot camp. Skilled workers, good at repetitive manual labor, make up 40% of our national workforce. But these guys don't love their work.
Dongguan has been called the factory of the world. From dress shoes to suits, from toys to electronic components. Over a span of 30 years, tens of millions of Chinese factory workers' hard work and efficiency have created this impressive, miraculous growth. As one of China's earliest finished goods exports, nearly 3 in 5 pairs of shoes in the world today are Chinese. Strength and militarized management and a high degree of goal-oriented focus enabled Zhang Huarong to lead Hua Jian into becoming China's largest producer of women's footwear. However, on this patch of what was once scorched earth, both early and late arrivals have experienced the thinness of the air.
Many shoe companies are currently trying to move out of China to increase profits by taking advantage of cheaper labor.
The shoe industry is a volatile one, always on the move. A company may have started in Italy, then moving to Brazil, followed by Taiwan, finally ending up in China. The trend now is moving to mainland China. This is Hua Jian in Ganzhou, Jiangxi province.
Raise your right hand up and down. Left hand and down. Now both hands!
Zhang Huarong foresaw the changing environment more than 10 years ago. In 2002, he went back to his hometown Jiangxi province and set up a manufacturing base. However, this still can't compete with the raising speed of labor costs. Companies in Pearl River Delta region started to move out to other countries, one after another.
In 2011, just about everyone looking for work were born in the 90s or later. Shoemaking is hard work. I remember during that time, of the 10 workers we hired that were handed out to my shift, all of them left after 1 week.
So for the target this month is 380,000 pairs, but only 289,000 pairs were made, and only 70% of the target was accomplished.
Look at this. The few thousand people we have at the bottom of the production chain don't know to say the reason, but always find a way to tell a story about the journey. How do I find the people to tell me the what, the when, or the how? Why don't you tell me?
I never told you, but this job may be for you too, this Dalong.
It's good. You're still young. Make the contract.
Yeah. Show the best of you. Can you do it?
Yes!
Okay, very good. Chao Yo, Zun!
Hero!
Chao Yo, Zun!
Hero!
Chao Ho, Zun!
Hero, Sun!
Chao Yo, Kao, Zun! Chao Che, Kun!
One of the largest shoe business companies, Brown Shoe, has been cooperating with Zhanghua Rong for many years. But they are a little bit worried if they can find gold within remote Africa.
Once we produce at least 1 or 2 million pairs of shoes, we will make these golden shoes.
After training in China, they'll eventually be able to speak English, Chinese, and Ethiopian. They'll make the business big in Ethiopia.
If you operate over there for a long time, 100% of the time you'll have a different factory over there.
Okay. You're the boss. I'll provide the services, logistics, and customs.
Ethiopia can be found a quarter of a global way from China, a traditionally agrarian country with 3,000 years of history located on the highlands of East Africa. It is learning from China's experiences during its opening and reform. As the country with the highest number of livestock in Africa, this country is also the producer of the world's highest quality leather. The most important factor in attracting investment is labor costs. For what it takes to hire one worker in China, one can hire 10 here. Of course, this implies that the investor must pay higher costs in other areas. The Eastern Industrial Park, located in Addis Ababa's municipal district, was paid for by Chinese investors as part of the Ethiopian government's Sustainable Development and Poverty Alleviation Program. Currently, a dozen of Chinese companies have entered the industrial park, and the locals refer to it as Chinatown.
I arrived on October 12th, hiring labor, finding factory space, and working out all the other details. It only really took 75 days. But December 27th, we were already manufacturing.
While Taiwanese companies were seeking to set up in the familiar territory of Southeast Asia, Zhanghua Rong chose to trailblaze, setting up in Africa. This was not an easy task.
The most difficult part of Chinese companies is establishing good contacts.
If you don't know English, you won't last.
When you're talking with them, they like to make body movements. Even when talking like we're doing now, they like to make gestures with their hands moving like this.
Ethiopia is a Western culture. Their pace is relatively slow. Quality of life is slow, but is also easier to fulfill. They're not as hardworking as us Chinese. Let me tell everyone, our productivity, when compared to Chinese companies, is only 50%, not even 70%. Our goal is to reach 70% of Chinese companies. The reason we make them go through this boot camp is to get them to realize our industry's culture, industrial needs, and regulations. Without discipline, there is no results. If your industry gets no results, then let me tell you, everything else is empty talk. Their foreman just saw all of this, and now they're feeling pride because they need an industry like this. He said China and Chinese industry is the model to follow. If you didn't even do that, then Wei Yongchun, what are you doing? I'm not looking for trouble, but who's responsible? Disperse!
Do you want spinach?
It's fine.
Spinach?
Yes, ma'am. Some more of that.
The influence is everywhere.
Have you ever had it?
No, never. But thank you. I tried some, but I gave it back.
Yeah.
It's sweet.
Is it good?
This is more like it. It's good.
If it's good, eat some more.
Thusly, industrial development has changed these men bit by bit, who come from an agricultural nation.
Your handicraft is so good. Such detail in such a small size.
like army and we are like, because first when you go to into work before you are prepared yourself, by army, motivate yourself.
China is very beautiful, okay? I say no beautiful. Therefore me, I learn this one. After that, I go to Iceland. I change my country, okay?
After opening and reform, we could do whatever we thought to do. Sell beer, rat poison, vegetable seeds, whatever. So many of us used to be soldiers, and I was considered one of the cultured ones. He couldn't write letters, neither could he. So I helped him write them. So this was the most competitive time. This is to say around 1999. I really liked cartography at the time. When I was in Jiangxi during the 80s, I really liked to look at maps. Because I knew where I was, China's size, after going to Guangdong, I was aware of what the world was like.
China's development, which changed the world, also changed the people of China.
Since I started my career 2 years ago, I believe the biggest impact I have experienced in that is my administrative abilities have become much stronger. When I have a kid, I'll make sure he gets a good education. We all need to be cultured individuals. Without that, it's impossible.
Listen!
Listen!
Look!
Look!
Close your book!
Close your
The world is changing to become more and more connected. The notion of distance is being redefined constantly. The world is becoming flat and everyone is redefining themselves.
But then we were downtown in Beijing, which was pretty interesting, and that's where I think Michael originally lived, and there was a lot of cool things to see down there, I think more so than in really the city of Beijing.
Paul is a legend in the world of motorcycle lovers. This is his first time in China.
Dreams. Today I want to talk to you about dreams.
The one welcoming in Paul is Li Changxian, who had grown up in Beijing's Hutongs. Today, Changxian realized a long-held wish. He had just earned the right to represent Paul's company, Orange County Choppers.
I came over here yesterday to take a sneak peek, but there was nothing. Later I realized there was a reason for the missing bikes. There needs to be an aura of mystery.
In the Orange County Chopper headquarters in New York, the atmosphere is thick with Western culture. Every motorcycle is handmade according to each customer's exact specifications. These machines are in a class of their own. Li Changxian will order three motorcycles, and he presented an interesting proposition. He wants to order a Chinese dragon motif bike. He believes that with the injection of Chinese culture, more Chinese people will be attracted to this novel, exotic product.
We will give you the traditional pictures of a Chinese dragon. Yeah, similar.
More like that?
Yeah. Chinese dragon has a five, what do you call it, paw, finger?
Five toes?
Five toes, yeah.
What does our dragon have on him? He's got four.
It's different.
Yeah.
You know, Michael came in here to do a dragon bike, and that's what we were going to give him, was a dragon bike. And was it like, kind of like, are you kidding me, type of like, to do that bike? What I found is that that China was pretty Americanized. And they kind of rode the same bikes as we did. I mean, I guess Harleys are popular down there.
Westerners have a different perception of dragons. They believe the dragons are symbols of evil.
The image of the dragon is transforming. In order for the world to understand China, Dialogue must go in both directions.
Yeah, we got some shadows going on. At first, Michael wanted more of a traditional Chinese dragon, and I really pushed back on him to let us do something that hasn't been seen before, some sort of creation that was 100% original, you know? This was printed out of plastic, printed.
The time to present the bike has arrived. Li Changxian can't wait to travel to America. Paul is currently preparing to give Li Changxian a big surprise in true American fashion. The mystery is about to be solved.
Ready? One, two, three, go!
Oh my God! Wow. Wow.
I can't believe this. This is great. It's really great. I never expected this. I didn't believe that they could do this so well.
This fender, because it has a 240 tire, so we had to get the width.
I'm so excited. I'm very happy. Thank you very much, Paul. Thank you all. This one? I forgot.
Okay, so you all live here?
No, I'm living in Beijing.
Beijing?
I just came here.
You gotta ship it?
Yeah.
The 44-year-old Li Changxian has been doing international business for more than 20 years. Traveling around the world has opened up his vision and brought him confidence. He defined himself as new Chinese for knowing the world by doing business. The new generation of Chinese are just stepping into the limelight. In the age of globalism, fashion companies draw from a talent pool of all skin colors and ethnicities. They are punctual, elegant, and self-disciplined. This is the economy of beauty, the stage that sets a price on physical appearance. Not every dream leads to fame, but all fame comes from dreams.
I've wanted to be a supermodel ever since I was a child. I'm 19 this year. This is my second season of Fashion Week. My goal is to walk in the New York Fashion Show. All of my heart yearns to fulfill my dreams. My idol is Liu Wen, of course. I really respect her as a professional and as a person. Her interactions are all so polite. Liu Wen is one of the top three models. That's impressive, one of China's marvels, one of Asia's marvels even.
Hi, my name is Liu Wen, I'm 25, and I'm from... Sorry, one more time, it's getting stressful. Okay, yeah. Hello, okay. Hi, I... okay, yeah. Hello, my name is Liu Wen, I'm 25, I'm from Hunan, China.
New York, the center of the world, a city filled with opportunity and competition. Countless people flock here to fulfill their dreams every day. Clothing manufacturers, designers, models, everyone in the fashion industry hopes to find their time in the limelight here. During the world's four seasonal fashion weeks, New York's Fashion Week features the most brands. Over a period of 8 days, over 140 brands will showcase thousands of outfits. Fashion is not only the product of art and design, but more importantly, is a product of commerce and industry.
Because there are a lot of designers here, their offices are also here. Jason Wu's is here, and Philip Lim's, as well as Vera Wang's.
China has only entered into the international fashion circles in the past few years. Liu Wen, who currently lives in the United States, is the closest connection to that world. The top international brand commented on Liu Wen that she has a simple and clean face.
That evolution doesn't necessarily happen overnight, especially in our business. Girls start as runway models, and if they have something really more to them, something really special, are able to then translate some of that newness and that success into a longer career.
A model can get the orders from their talent agency to head to the next interview at any time. And so, more and more Chinese models found themselves paying out of pocket to stay entire seasons at the four major fashion weeks.
Ugh, this is driving me crazy.
Wu Jiaye is from Shanghai. This is her second time in New York. She hopes this will open up a new world for her.
For the first 5 days here, I didn't have anything to eat because I didn't like the food here. The rent for a bedroom, $2,000. Multiply by 6 and you get the price in yuan. Some shows don't pay you for the session, but send some clothes instead. Something that made me happy was when I met a designer who from the bottom of his heart said, "I really like how you did this and that." That feeling of being noticed made me very happy. Annoying, I don't know which floor. Is this a wig or did you dye it?
It's dyed.
The interviews with those brands are done. Now's the time to choose the important interviews.
The world's youth are alike in their involuntary silence. Before starting their careers, models must go to talent agencies and undergo countless interviews. These companies decide who can ascend to the runway.
I have so less time, like I have this much time, I have to run to my next casting, like crazy, because it's so far and I have so many in between. Now you get email all the time, so you really have to run.
Compared to the young Wu Jiaye, Dong Yuanning already has a foothold in New York. The company that has hired her has previously turned Liu Wen into a star, which fills her with both hope and stress.
This year's trends have favored Japanese and Korean models, which has greatly impacted Chinese models' careers. Many venues are now employing more Koreans and Japanese, leaving us Chinese out of a job. This one's good.
Yeah.
This model is very good.
Yeah.
The best in this group.
Let me see you hold this. I said I think it suits you. I want them to stay.
This is very good.
This is very good.
Fashion business members from Shenzhen, China, invited by the host, are actively preparing to showcase in the international arena. China is now the largest clothes export country, but there is no internationally recognized brand.
She needs to be measured.
They have to come in on the morning of the 10th. I believe this is a process. Nobody dared come here before. But now that they're here, the boldness turns into talent. The will to let others see what we've got. And now that they're here, they have the spot on stage.
Driven by fans, increasing interest, imitation, trends, and street shoots have become very popular with Western models. Initially, Liu Wen was not very receptive to this business style.
the office.
Bye.
In the beginning, everyone didn't really get what street shots are all about and didn't seriously dress up for them. They only brought out their own views or their attitudes towards beauty and naturally expressed them.
A lot of fashion is born of what they call street fashion and, you know, people on the streets and what they're wearing, catching people's eyes. And that's why you have certain people like Bill Cunningham, who has been such a success with just spotting these people and taking their pictures. And you know, it sort of begins there. I don't think it's anybody really controlling anything, because if you go to the stores, if you look, you know, now with social media and the internet, I mean, there are so many designers and so many options for people to find what's right for them and with how they see themselves. So, you know, I think it's pretty democratic, actually.
She has several firsts under her belt. She's the first to obtain a contract with Estee Lauder, the first Chinese model to model for Victoria's Secret Seasons. She has also opened the doors for others and created more opportunities for Chinese models abroad, as well as represented the Chinese market as a kind of forecast for how far we've come. Let me tell you why I think so many Chinese models can appear in New York's Fashion Week or Milan's Fashion Week. It's because the Chinese market now has so many connections with the US and European markets.
We frequently bring up a slogan, from made in China to invented in China. This slogan has been brought up for many years, but now we've begun to slowly move towards it, step by step. It's slow going, but we're starting the journey.
I think it's beautiful.
Chinese people have never lacked the bravery and determination to embrace the world, even though everyone stands on different distance from the arena center. Liu Wen's hometown is in Hunan, where China also manufactured its earliest gift to the world. 90% of the fireworks that are used around the world are made in China, and 80% of that portion comes from this fireworks triangle. Here, fireworks are ubiquitous, almost like the blood flowing in one's veins. Li Tian is a household name here. Locals believe that 1,300 years ago, this Tang Dynasty man invented the first firework. They erect effigies and shrines dedicated to him, and pay their respects there every year on his birthday. Like many parts of Chinese history that are inseparable from myth, each town has its own records and ardently proclaims themselves as Li Tian's hometown. Luckily, these arguments are confined to an area the size of only several kilometers. Compared to the Li Tian sites at Liaoyang and Wanzai, Li Tian's old home in Shangli County is the most Spartan. Although it is the most visited, this eroded mountain is only recorded in documents as the sacred view.
That Li fellow's manual is over 6,000 years old. We know because the folks around here all made firecrackers, and all of those designs are by him.
Chen Daoyou's home is located right next to Li Tian's supposed home. Ever since his retirement, Chen Daoyou has served as the self-appointed caretaker of Li Tian's historical residence, as well as its researcher. To prove this old house is the former residence, Chen Daoyou came to the Nanju Mountain behind the house.
It's old sculpture. This is a founder. Firecrackers. This is the old house. They didn't call him the founder of firecrackers, but Saint Li Tian.
These are the manufacturing tools used last year. The steps to making firecrackers are simple and easy, and family members of all ages can participate. In a glorious display of fireworks, 80% of its beauty comes from the red soils of Jiangxi's hills. Few people would come to know the local culture and history of firecrackers now.
After seeing this intangible cultural heritage, I thought to myself, hurry up and use it. It's too mechanized these days.
Simple tools, meticulous craftsmanship, combined with intensive labor. This is the traditional Chinese manufacturing method passed down over thousands of years. Wanzai County, on the western periphery of Jiangxi Province, is currently undergoing urbanization. The pagoda tower in the center of the city dates back to the Tang Dynasty, but it has received a new lease on life.
I just went outside to talk business, so I just got back to clean. That premium time candle is for brewing glory.
When Chen Shimei took over the business from her father, she had just turned 30. Now she runs the largest foreign trade company in Wanzai.
When I attended school here for a little over 2 years, I think, it was right here, near Miami. And now our warehouses are in Indiana, over here, and there. I'm too short, I can't see it. Right now, we're discussing a joint project over in Pennsylvania. That's to say, Philadelphia, which is right next to Pittsburgh.
In China, if one can make money, one has an estate. And only with an estate can you develop. In business through the ages, a similar logic has prevailed.
Because I had never traveled before, I was very curious. It's like being in a walled city. Everyone inside wants to go out, while everyone outside wants in. I really wanted to go out. I had my luggage all packed up. My mother hurried home from the factory and stored it all away. She didn't want me to leave. She said, the family business is still looking to hire. Why are you trying to go work for someone else? Truth be told, when I was in the US, I didn't really listen to music. Look at these songs, they're all very old.
Products manufactured in China's barren hills are marketed in the most affluent areas all over the world. Chen Shimei often frequents the space between these two incongruous realms.
If you have a lot of money, frankly, you can go enjoy life to its fullest. They felt that they were rich, so they really spent most of their time at mahjong tables. I felt that was pointless. Look, this is camellia incense we import from Japan. I started selling this when I was a toddler. Look at where we are now.
We started producing this in the 1970s.
After the Deng Xiaoping era reforms, Wanzai began manufacturing fireworks. In order to minimize the risks involved in its manufacture, every step of the process was separated into its own workshop, operated by a single person.
These are our planes, scrap planes. We grind them into powder, then add them inside.
In the Middle East, say Lebanon or Palestine, pieces like this, they just carry these on their shoulders, just like that. Whereas over here, we wouldn't dare do that.
Once the different gunpowder mixtures and their different packagings are ignited in the fireworks display, they erupt into different shapes and colors. Their labyrinth factory complexes are hidden in the folds of the hills.
Fill the gaps in the crate. Try to pack some more in there. A crate is worth $10,000, regardless whether there's 800 or 1,000 boxes in there. If you put more, aren't you just giving away free merchandise? Because we grew up near firework factories and joined the business after graduating, it was a tremendous occasion to join the first fireworks festival. After I saw it, I really got goosebumps all over my body.
The Chinese invention of gunpowder has blossomed in the sky all over the entire world. The firework pipeline Highway 319 not only connects every city within the fireworks triangle, but also connects those cities with the entire world.
Back then we called it road fees. Every worker chipped in, each person a few thousand yuan. We all paid out of pocket. And we raised our funds just like that. And that way we opened up a tunnel through the Jiaoshaoling Mountains. This tunnel is slightly over 3 kilometers long, and it cuts through the winding National Highway 319, shortening the route. Now, it only takes 50 minutes to reach Changsha and its Huanghua Airport. In the past, thinking about going to Changsha was to dream of travel to a place far away, as far as the Arabian deserts. It was, to use a local saying, dreaming as they do in Liuyang. Now, this dream has become Liuyang's reality.
Enormous power could be found in the land of nowhere. A company is in Shenzhen's special economic zone, but was isolated in a corner of the industrial park. One Chinese gene sequencing company is experiencing its own historic expansion. The scientists don't just predict the future, they also like to do their part in making it reality. 21-year-old Zhao Bowen is already a world-renowned geneticist at the forefront of his field. He is currently leading an international team of expert academics in an endeavor to discover the link between genetics and human intelligence. Zhao Bowen enrolled in Beijing's Renmin University's Associate High School. During the summer of his junior year, he attended a summer camp. At the end of that camp, he dropped out of school and became an entrepreneur.
My parents were vacationing in Inner Mongolia then. They hurried over when they received the phone call. They traveled overnight to get here, and even my teacher, Mr. Wang, was here. He told my parents, "Let's discuss this privately." I didn't hear what they talked about, but by the end of it, my parents agreed to my decision.
Wang Jian is a so-called maverick scientist.
"I've worn these shoes for 3 years. They stay on no matter the season. I haven't changed them once."
In the 1980s, he researched genetics in the United States and was part of China's contribution to the International Human Genome Project in the 90s. He likes to describe his perspective of the scope of genetics as China's too small, the universe is too large, the Earth is just right.
All of biology is based in genetics. X-rays, CT scans, all that is useless. Because cancers start out inside your cells, and your cells are based on your DNA.
Genetics research doesn't just represent the human race's self-identity, but more importantly, it impacts the evolution of the biomedical industry. China not only has access to this field's cutting-edge techniques, but also has the people willing to perform the foundation work. Genetic sequencing is the first step towards reading genes. In 2010, Wang Jian spent $1.5 billion USD to purchase 128 of the latest American gene sequencing machines, establishing the world's largest gene sequencing and bioinformatics centers in one fell swoop. He wants to drive research with industry.
Over 80% of birth defects are due to abnormalities in the genetic code. That is irrefutable. The average person thinks that if it's down to genetics, I can read the code, then I can prevent defects from occurring in the kids, but not marrying people with risky genes. Physical attractiveness and wealth don't factor into the equation.
All right, smile. Yeah. Bring your head down just a little bit. All right, move your hand down just a touch.
He touched a very primal part of my inner psyche, the one that wants to discover something previously unknown to the entire world. This is sure to be something that is important to the entire human race and all of society.
The next generation's heartbeat accelerates the rate of scientific advancement. In 2012, the 36-year-old Wang Jun was selected as one of Nature magazine's top 10 scientists in the world. The university sophomore college dropout Li Yingrui became BGI's chief scientist and CEO at the age of 26. Controlling the direction of humanity's evolution is perhaps the loftiest goal for mankind. Wang Jian and his team hope that through their genome sequencing, obtaining millions of samples of gene sequences, and applying that bioinformatics to research could benefit the public. Let everyone use the fruit of their labors to achieve healthier lives. Wang Jian believes that his market has the potential to be worth over $1 trillion. Thus, his chosen motto is, "Service every nation's citizens first, then let their currency service me."
BGI's model is to provide both in one package. We have the base research, we have the techniques, we have industrial power, and we have international reach, and we have the IT know-how. It's a little wild, isn't it? It's crazy, huh?
BGI is responsible for half the gene sequencing output annually. It is already an indispensable link in the biotechnology industry's supply chain.
BGI can be said to be an international company from the start because its precursor was part of the Human Genome Project. That was an endeavor that involved six nations and over 3,000 scientists. Science transcends national borders.
Science may transcend borders, but scientists still hold nationalities. It's like the area in between a city and the countryside. Factories and warehouses all around, goods waiting to be shipped. When you enter late at night, the bright lights leave a very deep impression.
It takes raw manpower to analyze, categorize, and interpret the huge amounts of data gathered. For young workers here, qualifications are not an issue, and they get on-the-job training by participating in major scientific projects. These real opportunities attract thousands of biology experts who spend their time deciphering the world's DNA round the clock.
AI is how young it is. The average age is about 26 years old, and that is really, really very special. And the backgrounds of the people are from many, many different areas, which allows them to live in, let's say, almost a silo-free world, where they are not so rigid to one science or one discipline or one ideology, but are very open to new ways of looking at things. And of course, that's very important for genomics.
For critics, this amounts to nothing more than a factory that relies on instruments and demographics. But Wang Jian respects the adage, shot heard round the world. Without a loud enough bang, no one in the world will pay attention.
You may have heard of venture capital, but I'm doing venture science. I'm investing in science.
Say you don't want to follow orthodoxy. You want to make a breakthrough innovation. He'll give you the environment. No one has the luxury of a private office. When I went to see Mr. Wang, he was also sitting in a cubicle. Not even he had his own office.
A throne? What kind of a man do you take me for? No one at BGI talks about high-end customers. And if they did, I'd have them fired instantly. What makes anyone special? The machines certainly treat everyone's nucleotides the same.
We will use this kind of attitude to make our research benefit more people and affect more lives.
Why did we fall so behind over the last century? There are times when one needs to be introspective, when one takes stock of both strengths and weaknesses. Otherwise, only limbo awaits. I know who I am. I'm diligent. I'm brave. I'm smart. I'm creative. So what? Do something with it. This is our new headquarters. They're starting construction. The roads are finished.
In what will become China's future national gene bank lies over 90 kilometers of iron wiring separating the mainland and the special administration area. Following the passage of time, this fence's gate has become a memorial of the past. In Wang Jian's eyes, 30 years of introductions lie in the past, while 30 years of stepping outwards remains in the future.
As a resident of the Earth, I come from Africa originally. What difference does it make if I return there? It's time to return home.
I believe that things that are meaningful and productive are called business by everyone. How far away are we from the world? Not very far, but it's still an ordeal to close that gap. It hasn't changed. What it was like in the past is what it's like now. But China has changed greatly. Chinese people have stepped outside its borders to do business, becoming more confident in the process.
The world has been connected into a single body thanks to these new methods. In order to interact with this globalized environment, the Chinese people are set on a great new path.
China has been subjected to 300 years of torment and humiliation. Who wouldn't be mad? The best revenge? We're going to make them chase after us for change.
Not only are they making progress, they're also patient. This is a quality inherited from their ancestors. Like this country, they grow stronger with time. The globalized Chinese people never lacked in bravery or adventurous spirit.
Chance, opportunities, and money.
They traverse great physical distances, break through psychological boundaries, making their own way through the unknown in the face of doubt and conflict. Please follow the second episode of Doing Business with the World, Going the Distance.